Star Wars The Rise of Skywalker is said to have many different twists and turns, as well as surprises in this film by writer and director J.J. Abrams and Chris Terrio. This is Mike Zero. If you guys are new to the channel, do make sure to subscribe to see future Star Wars content. Now, what's really intriguing about this movie is that we do know that Episode 9 is going to offer a lot of new secrets to some of the legacy characters, as well as some of the sequel trilogy characters, right? We're talking, for example, Rey, Kylo Ren, Luke Skywalker, Darth Vader, Palpatine, the list goes on. And I think that the reason as to why The Rise of Skywalker is such a big movie is because, well, it's going to have a lot going for it, and it's going to have a major impact on the entire Skywalker saga. Now, these past couple of weeks or so, we've been learning a whole lot more about this film, and when it all comes down to one of the concept art descriptions, this is where things begin to get very exciting for this movie. Now, specifically, shot descriptions consisting of Kylo Ren and his Knights of Ren inside of the Dark Spire, where it's said that they eventually come across a large statue of Darth Vader that is said to hold many secrets from Vader's past. It's said that a creature greets Kylo and the Knights, where it's said that the creature reveals to Kylo that there is an opening in the back of the Vader statue that holds many relics and artifacts, one of which is said to be another Darth Vader helmet that is, however, not completed and without the top helmet piece, where the Forger explains that he was putting the helmet together until he learned of Vader's death. The next describes Kylo coming across a large box where he opens it, where it's said that a red kyber crystal is seen inside. The kyber crystal is said to appear in great shape and implies that it was used as a backup kyber crystal for Vader's saber. The last goes over Kylo discovering a device that is said to be glowing in a blue hue in the shape of a hexagon. It's said that this device originated from the beyond that Vader kept and is also used as a piece to the puzzle of finding a certain location in the beyond to the origins of the dark side of the Force. So, I want to go over a couple of parts about all of this, obviously, because Darth Vader is one of my favorite characters out there, and the fact that J.J. Abrams is really, you know, doing a great thing for the character of Vader, really kind of just giving us a little bit more backstory on the character of what happened in between the events of the prequels and the originals, and exactly what things Vader kept away in his vaults, and of course, inside of this statue that was actually taken from some Force protectors or dark side worshippers of some kind. So the first piece that I do want to go over is another Vader helmet. Now, this was actually being created by the Forger, which is an ancient being, a monkey-like creature that actually created Kylo Ren's helmet and the Knights of Ren's helmets. And this creature actually explains to Kylo and the Knights that he was actually constructing a new Darth Vader helmet until he learned about Darth Vader's death, where he ultimately stopped and kept it stored within Vader's statue. So this to me sounds like it's a great callback to really telling us that there was at least more than one Darth Vader helmet that was actually in existence or was going to be in existence at a certain point in time, just before Darth Vader's death. Now, this one is described to be the regular helmet except without the top piece. So it's basically imagine the Vader helmet without the top piece at all. So the other piece that I do want to go over is how Kylo Ren eventually comes across a box that actually contains a red kyber crystal that implies and is described to be a backup kyber crystal that was actually going to be used for Darth Vader's lightsaber at some point in time in the future. Now, I don't know about you guys, but it really seems like Disney and Lucasfilm, they're trying their very best in order to really make kyber crystals and holocrons and everything around those lines very much, I guess you could say, familiar with the casual Star Wars fan that goes ahead and sees this movie and watches the previous movies. So, going forward, we're going to be learning a whole lot more about holocrons and kyber crystals in this movie, and even in the new Star Wars trilogy by the creators of Game of Thrones, David Benioff and D.B. Weiss, came across that will serve as a puzzle, a piece to the puzzle, that leads to the origins of the Force, a specific location within the beyond that the Knights of Ren were searching for, however they were unsuccessful. So, in case you guys did not know, there is going to be a big element to the Knights of Ren in this movie where it's going to be explained as to why they were actually gone for The Force Awakens and The Last Jedi, is because they were actually over in the beyond, searching for that exact location, the origins of the dark side, and a certain pinpoint in the beyond that led them to that location, and they never found it. So they were unsuccessful, they need pieces to the puzzle in order to get there. And this Darth Vader, you know, secret, this relic, if you will, is actually going to help them on their quest in order to go over to the beyond and discover that exact location. So what do I make about all this? All these different Darth Vader secrets and all these little connections to the beyond. I think it's great. It really seems like that this movie is going to be very heavy on, you know, Jedi lore, Sith lore, and other forms of lore out there that we have never seen on the big screen in history. So this really is a big deal as far as the Star Wars movie goes, because not only will it loosely connect to the new and upcoming Star Wars trilogy in the 2020s, but it's also going to be used in a sense in order to not just be the end of the sequels, but to be a true ending of the 8 films that come before it. And you can only imagine how much stress, you know, J.J. Abrams went through in order to get this movie right, and still is trying to get right during post-production and reshoots. Anyways, guys, drop a comment below. Let me know what you think about all of this in the comments. And if you guys did enjoy the content for today, do make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel. I thank you all so very much for the kind support, and I'll catch you guys next time.